zombie apocalypse. So, I am doing what any furry would do during the zombie apocalypse. I will be disguising myself as an animal. But first, I have to brush him to make sure that the fur will trick the zombies. Don't worry if a zombie bursts through the door. I have scissors to deal with the zombie, so I will be safe if no more than 5,000 zombies breaks through my door. The slicing of the scissors can get rid of up to 1,000 zombies a second. So sharp, so don't worry about me unless 5,001 zombies breaks through the door, okay? Okay, now what we are going to do is put on the fursuit and brush until we are able to trick the zombies. I have my first paw. And now I'm going to put on my first paw so that I am partially disguised. By wearing one paw, I will be able to trick 20% of the zombies. So I'm going to put it on now. As you can hear, the paws do not make human sounding skin noises. So if I touched sound like paws rather than human skin. So yes, that is a very good thing. Okay. I thought I heard something, but it was just my neighbor running away on his motorcycle. Unfortunately for him, he did not have a fursuit. So, there is an army of 5,001 zombies currently chasing after him. So his scissors will not save him from that. He was a nice guy. I'm gonna miss him. Okay, it is now time to put on the second fursuit paw. Okay, so let's put it on. Because the second one will give me more protection from the zombies. Okay, now I have I should have about 50-60% camouflage against the zombies that are now taking over the entire world. I am safe though, as I said. I am locked in a moderately secure room, and I have my zombie slaying scissors, and in addition, I have 50% or 60% camouflage. Sounds will trick any zombie, or at least most of them, into believing that I am not actually a human, but instead a neon animal. And so they will 50-60% leave me alone. Okay. I was just testing to see how non-human it would sound if I had to casually stroke a zombie's face. Calm it down and made sure it got a good night's rest, because even though it wants to devour flesh, that does not mean it should not get its proper sleep. So I wanted to be able to put zombies to sleep as well, but not get turned into a zombie. I am what you would call a pacifist in that regard. Okay, now it is time to go and brush the fursuit paws. I have my brush, and I will be brushing both paws, because when I have my head on, I can't hear too well. Okay, so let us begin. I think I will start with this paw, because I just want to start with this paw. Remember, if you have a brush that is angled, you need to brush just like this so that the angle is pointing up. If you do that, can avoid tearing out the fur. You do not want to tear out too much fur, because fursuit makers are either eaten already or they are hiding. So you have to preserve your fursuit in order to stay alive. To do that, you have to prevent yourself from tearing out as much fur as you can. Brush down. safer spot, which is a furry convention, because the zombies will know that there are no humans inside and will go to the anime convention to get their brains. So the safest place to be during the zombie apocalypse, as we all know, is a furry convention, because almost everyone there are animals, not humans. At least that's what the zombies believe. I should know, because last year I was actually a zombie, so I know how they think, and I just don't want to be a zombie again. It's a different story, and I'll get back to that maybe in a future video. So yeah, I think we should brush this part now. Okay, so let's do that. Remember, you should brush down and not tear up the fur. Some good brushing right there. I think this is some good brushing. Don't you agree? Ah, my paw seems to be coming off a little bit. Okay, back to brushing. Just needs a little bit more brushing. Okay, so this paw looks good. And this paw also looks good. Just retesting to make sure that it still sounds like a animal, not a human. Okay, so now that we are brushed, we are safely 65 to 70% disguised from the zombies. Now, if any of you do not have a fursuit, there are still people on the dealer's den selling fursuits. I don't exactly understand why you would sell your fursuit during the zombie apocalypse, but there are people who are doing that. And if you have about $500 or $600, you can go and get a mini partial to protect yourself from the zombies. But if you don't have that much, then for about $100 or $200, you can get 60% or 70% protection from the zombies by getting yourself some hand paws and a brush. Because remember, properly brushing fursuit paws will give you 70% protection, maybe even 75% protection, if you brush good enough. Okay, so 100% protected. To be 100% protected, you need to have the fursuit head too. Now you can fursuit, but that's a little overkill because you can start to stink like a human. And then the zombies will see you through your disguise and will come and eat you alive. And so you'll be hurting other furries because we don't know who to trust anymore. So yeah, go for the partial, but not a full suit. Okay, now it's time to brush the head, the final part of our zombie disguise. Remember, you need to brush down. Brush down, not up. Keep as much fur as you possibly can. It's a little risky, but I had to take off my paws to brush my head. Remember, it is safe to do so if you have your scissors, because it can take out at least 5,000 zombies. 5,001 if you are very good at scissors. And I'm gonna put these over here while I get to the main part, which is to brush my fursuit head. Okay, so here we are with the main part, which is the head itself. And now, gentle brushing. A little bit over here. Something, but again, it was my second neighbor trying to escape with a pup hood, and a pup hood by itself is maybe okay for protection, but it's not the best. It can distract maybe 5% of zombies, but you're better with paws if you have to. So yeah, a pup hood is if you have nothing else. this side, I think. Of course, I forgot. You have to brush the front too. Disguise to escape. First, I'm gonna put on my head. Gotta check to make sure that it's on properly, because it has to be on properly in order to escape properly. Okay, so I think this is on properly. That is good, very good. Now we gotta put on our paws. First, we will put on this one. Okay, so we have this one on. We are now 85% protected from zombies. We have to sell the illusion by putting on the final paw to our disguise. And so this is the other paw. And we will be putting it on right now. Remember, this will help you survive the zombie apocalypse. Okay, just some taps. Okay, so that works. And I think we have our disguise put together. We just gotta do some final test run. That does not sound like a human touch. Okay, so this works. And this works. Okay, so our disguise is now completed and we can safely escape and go face the zombie horde. We are 100% protected now. Oh, you're saying, what about all of the skin that's showing? You mean all of this? As well as all of this. Okay, so that's fine. That's completely fine. Because you see, as long as the zombies cannot see your face and hands, then the zombies will think that all of you is covered in fur. It's an optical illusion. The zombies will see this, and this, and this, and they will think that all of this, and all of this is also made out of fur. And so the zombies will think that you are 100% an animal. to survive a zombie apocalypse. And hopefully when this is all over, I will see you soon. And if you are in my area, then I hope to see you at the furry convention made to survive the zombie.